Hi! This video is about a feature allowing you to set up a custom modular grid in Zero Block. You can set the modular grid by yourself now. The grid helps you define the basic structure of your design and work faster with the layout. It creates a unified layout of all the elements and blocks of the website and helps to maintain the visual order. By default, Tilda uses the 12-column grid, but now you can change the number of columns and the distance, add horizontal lines, adjust the color, etc. Let's look at how to customize the grid to our taste. To do it, go to the Zero Block editor, open the artboard settings, and scroll down to the Zero Block settings option below. After clicking on the Open button, you'll see the workspace settings. The grid is set separately for each type of display resolution. That is, it will be different for desktop and mobile devices. To turn the grid on and off, you can type G on the keyboard, switch the height grid here, or click the button with three dots in the right top corner of the screen and select Height Grid or Show Grid. Now let's go back to the grid settings. Let's figure out what each of the fields is used for. In the Columns field, you can specify how many columns the grid should contain. I'll set 4 columns for my example. You can see at once that the amount of columns has changed. The Column Width option defines the width of columns. Here I specify 240 pixels, for example. The width has changed, and so has the spacing between columns. The next option is called the Column Gutter. This field is connected to the column width and the column margins. That is, if you change the value for one of these options, the Column Gutter value will also change, depending on the number of columns in the artboard. To be sure that the value you've configured won't change, you can lock it by clicking the lock icon near the relevant option. I can also specify the column margins or column spaces to the left and to the right of the artboard edge. These options are also specified in pixels. Besides vertical columns, you can also adjust the horizontal grid until the Zero Block. It's usually set for typography. The row baseline defines the spacing for the horizontal grid. This value is usually selected according to the basic size of the chosen font. For example, if you want to use a font of, let's say, 14 pixels with a line spacing of 20 pixels for the main text, then the row baseline value is also 20 pixels. The next option is the module height. You can use it if you add repeating modules in your design. For example, if I put 5 here, there will be an empty row every 5 rows, and the module will begin again. The row margins are the spaces below and above the artboard edge. I'll use the default values for this field. I've configured all the options for the unique grid. You can continue by specifying colors for your grid. The first option is the color of the columns. The color opacity is equal to 0 by default, so the columns field is invisible. If I increase the opacity percentage, I get the visible colored columns. You can see that now there is an empty row every 5 rows, as I've specified in the module height field before. Let's change the blue grid color to the red color. I can also adjust the border opacity. It is equal to 10% by default, and I change it to 20%, for example. Adjust the colors for your grid to be more contrasting and visible on the background you want to use. That is ready. Click the Save button to save the grid settings. Note that by default the grid settings are specified for the whole project. If I create a new Zero Block, I get the same modular grid in it that I've just configured. It is convenient to keep design integrity on different project pages. In case you want to use the unique grid just for the specific block, go back to the grid settings. And select the current block value for the Use For option. The settings will be applied just to the current block, and the other blocks will use the default grid. If you want, you can always reset the changes and restore the default grid. To do that, click the Reset Grid Settings to Default button at the bottom of the Zero Block settings and save the changes. Thanks for watching and good luck with creating wonderful websites. Bye!